Hello there, good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London, and Colin Harrington is joining us here from Zephyr Energy this morning because big news, you have successfully completed the drilling of the state 16-2LNCC, as you call it, the well there in the Paradox Basin in Utah, reaching a target depth of 14,370 feet. So we're going to talk through all of the detail and more. We're going to rewind and go right from the beginning. Colin, good to see you. Maybe kickstart this conversation by giving us a bit of context, if you could.
Sure, happy to, and good to see you as well. I'm just back from the desert, so it's been wonderful to be out there. And as you say, yes, great news that we have concluded the drilling of the well. As you remember, we had a vertical well that was there and cased down to about 6,400 feet. And what we did was go down to the bottom of that casing and then kick out, drill through all the overlying reservoirs to get to the Cane Creek, which was our target, and then drill out laterally from that point. So, you know, the good news is that we managed to drill through the overlying reservoirs. We saw good evidence of hydrocarbon charge across those, which is just what we saw the last time we drilled through them, but it's always nice to have that confirmatory evidence. Mm-hmm. But from my standpoint, the really big news was hitting the Cane Creek successfully and managing to drill 100% in zone across those 4,555 feet of lateral till we hit TD. And, you know, this is not like drilling in the Bakken or the DJ, which is very well understood. This is, you know, new for this area, this type of lateral. So the fact that we were able to rely on our 3D, stay in zone all the way across and have very good hydrocarbon charge across that lateral as well, to me was just fantastic news. So drilling went as we expected. And, you know, as you know, it doesn't always do that. So I was thrilled that it did in this case. So that's the first big takeaway. Second takeaway is we then ran in with open hole wireline logs, took them down to the toe of the lateral and then pulled them out and got logs, a full suite of logs all the way across the Cane Creek and then back up into the overlying reservoirs. So that data is good. It's being processed right now. We have a big team of people working on that behind the scenes, and we should have some news to release soon on what the logs have found. So that's underway. The last thing was, given all the positive signs that we had seen and the fact that we drilled exactly as we wanted to and pierced the Cane Creek exactly as we hoped to, we elected to run production casing and cement that. We've done that. We finished those operations just the other day, and we've now concluded with that and released the rig. So good news all around. Everything from an operational standpoint went very, very well.
You mentioned there the evaluation of the logs is underway. So we're waiting for those imminently, I presume.
Yes, we have a lot of work ongoing. It's not something that will take terribly long in this case. We do have a team of people working on that, as I said, and we expect to have the data from that and potentially from a pressure test as well out in the near term. And the reason these are important is it'll help us determine how we're going to complete the well. Because the lateral did manage to pierce the Cane Creek all the way across and we, you know, feel really well situated there, it gives us some options on how to best complete this. We want to take the optimal course, obviously, and so we're going to push forward with that, and we should have news out to the market there soon.
Good stuff. We look forward to that. Anything else you want to tell us about what's coming next for Zephyr?
Yeah, well, obviously, you know, we're moving towards completion and production testing on this well. We very much think that'll kick off here shortly, so that's coming up. As you know, we've also, on the other side of our portfolio, we're now producing all seven of our wells in North Dakota. And we should have some data on peak production rates and production rates overall from that in the near term. As people know, you know, these wells come on, they can come on very high, but oftentimes they are, you know, they're eased in and we're getting that production data waiting to get to peak, and we'll release that shortly. Really happy with how it's unfolding though. And then, you know, I think it's been clear, we've completed three acquisitions in the last 6 months. We've done the Whiting Wells, the Harms Wells, and more acreage out in Utah. We are always looking for other deals. The market is still great. And if we can find something that's highly accretive to shareholders and meets all of our very specific criteria, we'll certainly not hesitate to put more into the fold here. So lots going on, really happy with how it's unfolding and look forward to updating everybody else very soon.
Quite right. On the lookout there. Colin Harrington, thank you very much from Zephyr Energy here on Proactive this afternoon.
Thanks, Katie. Have a good day.